So, we don't have editing controls to add a quiz, then? On what? Hey, you always try to use Moodle terminology, no on, off. Please click on the button, turn editing on. You always use yes, no, only, it's a very abbreviated form of response. I have been observing her. You don't want to waste your energy or what? Okay. Click on. Are it's morning, still morning. Already got exhausted, Okay. Then, on the activity chooser screen, under activities you have quiz. Check the radial button, read through all this description. Whenever you find time and click on add. And give a specific name, don't just give quiz 1, 2, 3, 4, something. If it is for, if you are formative assessment, something. How do you generally administer quiz? Okay, expand all as always. Yeah, give a specific name to your quiz. Quiz on so and so module, quiz on so and so chapter, quiz on so and so, something. Now it should start with quiz or at the end also, something, somewhere. Be specific with activities. Okay, this is again important, description box is meant for instructions. We need to provide detailed instructions. Generally, for while administering a quiz, what do you have on this print copy? Answer all questions carry equal, what all, something we have, no? And also, don't forget to give quiz start and end time, and you also tell them it's a time bound quiz of 30 minute or 10 minute, 15 minute. That is also important. It's a time bound quiz of so and so minutes, duration of the quiz, and start date and time and end date and time. Quiz start and on the next line. Later you can update just, but yeah, quiz end date and time. Okay, we'll do that. Okay, and if you scroll down to this timing area, so here one important point is there to remember. Please, can I have your attention, all of you? Please stop working. One important point is there. Say for example, you assume that my quiz is ready. For tomorrow, I want to open, then you check this box and set the date and time and everything. Tonight, you may think, I want to add two more questions. So, next day, it will not allow you to edit the quiz on the same date. Please remember, if you are 100% sure and confident, then only enable this. Otherwise, just before the quiz, 10 minutes or 30 minutes, you can check these boxes. Please remember. It's very important. It will not allow us to edit on the same day. Okay? I mean previous day till 11:59 you can edit that. Okay then. Then what is today's time? This is. No, no, no. Generally you open on the same day, no? You give two days, huh? We never do that. Assignment though, we can open for 3 days. Because you have bandwidth issue. Okay then. Okay, please all of you open this today so that your students will attempt this quiz. All of you. So open this, you can uncheck this. This is only for practice purpose so that they can attempt. And you enable this, always you can enable. And how many minutes your quiz? Okay, you want to pick up 10 questions from, okay then. And this is again important, actually. You should configure this, it's a LMS training. Configure this at the site level. Open attempts are submitted automatically. This is very important. Yeah. I'll tell them. Moodle admin team. You log in as admin and set this. At the site level, you need to configure some of this. Open attempts are submitted automatically. This quiz settings, login as site admin and go to quiz settings and change this to by default, and this also under assignment also, student need to require on submit button. Two more options are there. You open, I'm coming. Okay, I'll tell you what are these two. Yeah, if you want to know more about this, can you click on this question mark, okay, help icon? Let them understand what is this. Advantage of this is automatically attempted questions will be submitted.
Just don't forget to press submit button also, it will take the answer.
Yeah, already attempted answers will be considered. Okay. Please don't forget, this is very important. Generally we don't give grace period. Highest grade, okay. Yeah, under this. Which one? No, no, change that to one. If it is a practice quiz, you can provide two or three multiple attempts. When you are taking this as an assessment component, then change, only single attempt will allow. And coming to the question order, this is very important. Shuffle randomly. The sequence of questions will be shuffled. This is important. Okay. And again, coming to this new page, never use the first one. Never all questions on one page. Quiz is resource intensive. If at the end of this quiz, say for example 3:15, everyone starts attempting, again you may face, students may face issue, server hanging issues and all. So every 5 questions is better, so that they can click on next, so automatically all these 5 answers will be saved. So you need to avoid load on server. Shuffle within questions, yes. And by default, deferred feedback, this is once everything is over, then only student will be able to see the feedback, means the correct answer, and they can review. And one more important point is, under this, you uncheck right answer. Yes, right answer. Only once after the quiz closed, otherwise, they always have mutual understanding, they'll get the right answer and share the right answer. And the first quiz itself, we faced this at IBS Mumbai campus.
But they may be
curious to know their marks, no? Yeah, it's up to you. You can, but only okay. But this is a must. Uncheck this. It's up to you. You can uncheck all these. If you open up all these options after the quiz is closed, it's up to you. Okay?
Because what happened, like if you get 7, so they know which 7 actually answered. So if it comes back any time, so
can get it. No, then here random questions are, it's not.
I don't know, so many students, right? Few questions obviously
repeat. Oh, you have, okay.
That's why.
Okay, you can, I don't know, depending on your scenario and students' behavior and all, you can check and uncheck, I don't know. Yeah. So, Amin Chaudhary, he prefers only the last one, okay? You may also decide, okay, call on that. So, say for example, as a student, I submit your quiz. Immediately after I submit, if I get all this, I may start sharing right answer with my friends. So, you uncheck. Once the date and time is over, then only everything will be open for your students, including their marks, questions. They'll get a link, review link. If they click on that, they'll get to know. So, where did it go wrong and everything. Okay. This is for student. Reviewing their attempt. This is meant for students. Okay? If it is a practice quiz, you can check all this. One time now. This is, you want multiple attempts, then you can. Only one attempt. So you scroll. Can you show, can you scroll up and show single attempt? You should change that to single attempt. Yeah, this, you please change this to single attempt. Okay? If it is a practice quiz, you can change this to 2 or 3, and you can take here average or highest, then it will be activated. And even the review options also, you can enable all the review options. Okay. Now, if you want to administer and allow your students to attempt these multiple attempts, then we can do. But our interest is only single attempt. So, all these will be deactivated. Scroll down. And we have unchecked all these. And scroll down, extra restriction on attempts, no any other restrictions. Scroll down. You can give, this is general feedback. If it is 90% plus, we are not doing all this. Yes. Okay, scroll down. Even change this to no groups. This is not a group activity. Okay. And change this. This is important again. Activity completion criteria. Yes. And you know, grade. Yes. View automatically, grade means automatically they attempt then only. Okay. Then save and display or save and return to course. So now in the, now we'll have course administration block. It will become contextual. That is quiz. Now it is changed to quiz administration. You can preview, click on preview to preview the quiz. Yeah, quiz is resource intensive. Quiz and H5P interactive content, all these are resource intensive. You need to upgrade your infrastructure, and your server should be high-end server, Moodle server should also be, all these. I think all these will be addressed by your e-learning center and your tech support team. I'm not the right person. Huh? Want a break? Cannot? So quiz is resource intense, so really we need to address. You are from the e-learning center and you are complaining this, huh? I think I remember in IIT Bombay, I think I asked only, then I had 100 participants. Only first two rows, please attempt, wait for, let them complete, then next two rows attempt. It was a Herculean task. Imagine controlling 100 faculty members, not students, 100 engineering college faculty members. Sir, when will last row, please get up. Okay, then we'll break for a tea then. Yeah, please. You stop this and save it. Not we need a tea break. Your Moodle server needs a tea break. These people should be so proactive and active in such scenarios. Say suddenly a faculty member starts administering a quiz, something happens, then if they don't address, in our scenario though, so it's like real time. Yes, always, whenever they have a quiz, immediately they call me, not even a single second they wait, let the server load, let the server, they never do that. Yes, it should be incorporated in your tele policy itself.